Hi, third graders. Here is a read aloud of this story for those of you who would rather listen than read. Mom, do you think we could get hummingbirds to come to our house? Carlos asked his mother. I saw some today on our school field trip to the botanical gardens. Sure. Any ideas on how to attract them? Asked Mom. A sign at the botanical gardens described the flowers they like, said Carlos. Let's check out the flowers on the porch, said Mom. They were purple and white petunias in one planter. Yellow marigolds were planted in the other one. Carlos pointed to the round, puffy marigolds. These aren't the right shape. The flowers need to be bell-shaped, like these petunias. Their long beaks drink the nectar inside. So we have the right flowers? Questioned Mom. They're the right shape, but the wrong color. Hummingbirds like flowers that are red. Can we get some red ones at the garden store? The next day, Mom brought home some red petunias. Carlos helped her plant them. He watched and watched. No hummingbirds came. Carlos wondered what else they could do. He researched online for ideas. Here's what we need, Carlos pointed to the computer screen. A hummingbird feeder. The hummingbird feeder looked very different from a regular bird feeder. It was made of clear and red plastic. It wasn't filled with bird seed. There was a clear liquid inside. Can we go get one? Carlos asked. Saturday, Mom said. Have you done all your homework? I'm studying hummingbirds. That's science, said Carlos, laughing. On Saturday, Carlos and his mother bought a hummingbird feeder from the garden store. The feeder came with a simple recipe for hummingbird nectar. They boiled water and added sugar. They let it cool in the fridge. Then they filled the feeder and hung it outside. So, how long until the hummingbirds come? Carlos asked. Be patient, Mom said. No birds came on Saturday. Carlos thought being patient was boring. He woke up early on Sunday and went to look at the feeder. Around it were three tiny birds. Their little wings were beating so fast they were a blur. Two dipped their beaks into the feeder. The third bird darted over to a red petunia. Carlos went to get his mother. When they got back, the birds were gone. Mom frowned. I missed them. Be patient, Mom, said Carlos. I'm sure they'll be back soon. And of course, Carlos was right.